Everybody, welcome back to Green Country Baits. We got a custom paint session for you today where we're going to be matching this real old trout pattern. So it's a little bit different. I haven't done very many trout patterns, so this is something new for me. Hope you guys want to learn something about this. And if you know what this lure is, this is a Dalton Special. Highly collectible. Looks like a wooden prop bait. But anyway, we're going to be putting this color on top water and on a favorite crankbait. Let's go spray some paint. We got a little trout pattern here off of the old Dalton Special. We're going to attempt to put that on this Yoziri BD3. So just kind of looking at the bait, fairly simple. We need a bone color, which we've already got applied. looks like we've got, I'm going to utilize a sap green for the lighter shades of green. A moss green back, probably two or three coats. But this trout, to me, it's a deep red, but that's a little bit tricky of a color right there. Okay, so we're going to try a deep red mixed with some magenta and a little brown, I think. So we'll see how close we can get to it. So anyway, folks, how about a complete custom? Or a match the bait session here today. So let's get started with our sap green. I'm just using a Comart sap green. And we're gonna do the lower portion. Back. Lightly hit the shoulders. Give that a quick heat set. See a little more of that sap green over here. Pressure running just a little high. It's pretty light, but looks good. I think I'm gonna darken it up just a tad. Light, and I want to go around those eyes. Moss green down the back. Mm-hmm.
Let's look at that back. Yeah, I need to put another coat. Darken that up. Okay, so now let's try a red color, and it looks a little bit red, but not really the same, is it? Not really the same. So we're going to have to cover that, go over the top of that with a little bit of either a burnt sienna, and we'll darken that right up. See, it's a little bit more of a brown and brown red on this trout pattern. Let's see. Or how about a red oxide? We do a little bit of a color change here. If you'll bear with me. Appreciate you guys coming back to check me out if you'd have. Hell, it's been 6-8 weeks since, or months, since I painted. But this time of year is generally when I kind of get back into it and able to push out some videos to you. But summer times have been extremely busy, although my son's a senior this year, and so I think summer travel prospect ball is going to be definitely slowed down. In fact, Brock has made his college commitment, and so we're looking forward to that in a year from now. All right, so what we're going to look at here is this red oxide. And it's pretty close. That's kind of got that pinkish. What I'm thinking is we're just going to try just a little bit of it here. There's this red oxide. It's got quite a bit of orange in it, actually. But we'll try a little bit on this and just see. We just tint that a little bit. I think that's getting a lot closer. darkens it up just a little bit. Still got a little more of a red tint than that, but really, really close. I kind of like that. Matching these old baits is extremely difficult, especially on odd colors like this. But hey, feel pretty good about it. So what we're going to use for our spots, now we could just get out here and get a fine paintbrush, but I'm going to utilize some of these FX textures, and we're going to come back over that with our moss green and do our trout pattern. I think I want a little bit of the bigger, larger. Yeah. Reds are still a shade off. I'll have to dig in a little bit deeper, and we'll see what sort of color combos we can come up with to get that a little bit closer to 100% match, but I really like it. I think it's extremely close. Guess we need to add some little dots to the bottom of it. We'll use a little nail and mix up some of those colors and get that dialed in. We got 8 that are about the same size. Now, this is going to be a challenge with this rough texture. Yeah, going to be quite a challenge. I got to straighten that one up a little bit. Get my paint cup here. Hard to get it uniform because it wants to flow into those little crevices. Yeah. Okay. All right. Well, tell me what you think. Not done many trout patterns. Live here in the South. We don't really hadn't fished any, but I'm going to paint this on a DD22. And we're going to go try that a little bit in our lakes and around here and just see. I've never really thrown many trout patterns. So anyway, guys, appreciate you stopping in. Check out the custom paint. We've got an old trout pattern here we've matched. See you next week.